Don't get into it because it will ruin your life. The doctors told me it was going to be a good 6 to 12 months before I could walk properly again, which scared the hell out of me. It's too addictive. Next thing you know, everything will revolve around getting more time out in the water.
I just feel so lucky and so blessed to be part of it, but to be part of it from so early on is just the best thing in the world. Heaps of different styles, you know, it's like the old school big air and spins, board off, kite loops, wag style and handle passes. I think it's such a shame when people restrict themselves to one style or another. They say, you know, this is cool and that's not cool. If you're ripping, you're ripping. The thing that got me hooked about karting was the power moves. So like two moves that you can feel the power of the kite. There's no such thing as a perfect board. You're always going to ride it and think this could be a little bit better, or I wish the board didn't do this, or I wish it did do this. You spend a bit of time thinking about how to change that feeling into measurements. Make the rails thicker or change the rocker or whatever. It's something you spend a lifetime playing with and still never get it perfect.
Just landed awkwardly and heard this disgusting noise.
When it broke, it sort of overlapped and the top piece went down into the ankle joint and sliced up some cartilage. And then they had to put a plate and a few pins and stuff in there. And that was actually the first serious injury that I'd ever had. They just haven't stopped. Cutting through winter in WA is all out or nothing, really. Different days, different moves, different conditions. More fun than sitting on the couch.
Hindsight, I probably should have put that extra layer of glass in.
Arse!
You just can't beat borrowed gear, can you?
I've been nearly as unlucky with my equipment as I have been with my injuries. As my knee's been healing up and I've been getting into powered tight loops and the more powered wake style trips and stuff again, I'm having to put more and more layers of glass and carbon and Kevlar and getting quite funky with it to just stop them breaking, basically. Yeah, making board with poisonous glue on epoxy fiberglass resin in a confined space, it messes with your head. This summer I spent a lot of time working on the handle passes and the wake style tricks. I'll leave the beach thinking, yeah, I'm gonna go out and learn this move today. 10 minutes after being on the water, I find that it doesn't interest me anymore. I've found something more fun, more exciting to work on and learn in that particular session. After breaking my ankle and popping my knee, and having it taken away from me twice, it sort of taught me to appreciate it a lot more. Before I had either of those injuries, I used to go out and just get so frustrated if you couldn't learn that new move on that day. If you're not having fun and you're stressing out, then what's the point of doing it anyway, you know?
Yeah.
Have fun, man. That's what it's all about. Don't get too worked up and angry about it. That's it. Done.